In our previous lectures, you have learnt that multiplication of matrices is not commutative. Well, what does that mean? That if you change the order, that is AB, if there are two matrices, say matrix A and matrix B, and you find out AB, that will not give you the same result as BA, that is matrix B into matrix A. Well, there are some more properties of matrices like this, multiplication of matrices. Let us see what are they. See, here we have given you three matrices, A, B and C. Well, do you think that AB into C will give you the same result as A into BC? Well, if we take normal numbers, say 2, 3 and 4. So, if according to this, I multiply 2 into 3 and then multiply 4 with it, or I multiply 3 into 4 and then multiply 2 with it, won't it give me the same result? Yes, it will give me the same result, because multiplication of normal numbers is commutative and also distributive and associative. Well, let us see whether these matrices satisfy this equation. If they satisfy this equation, we will say that matrices or multiplication of matrices is associative. Let us see whether these satisfy this or not. Well, you will help me in doing this. Find out AB first. We will do the LHS part first and then we will do the RHS part. So, in LHS part, we will do first the bracket part, that is finding out AB. Now, you are very well familiar with finding out the or doing multiplication of two matrices. First of all, what do you need to do? You need to check whether two matrices are multiplicable or not. Are they comfortable, or you can say, are they conformable in multiplying or not? Well, how do we check that in matrices? M into N, that is M by N into N by P should give you M by P. So, the number of columns of the first matrix should be equal to the number of rows of the second matrix. So, here if we look at A and B, both have the order 2 by 2. You can see that. So, the number of columns of A is 2 and number of rows of B is 2. So, both are same. So, they are multiplicable. So, now find out AB and tell me, what do you get? See, when we multiply A and B, we get 17, 7, minus 4 and minus 8. Now, what do we need to do? We need to multiply matrix A to AB, right? So, what we will do? We will multiply this matrix, that is AB, with the matrix C. Again, what we need to check? Whether these two are multiplicable or not. Look at the order of AB, 2 by 2, right? 2 rows and 2 columns. Now look at C, 2 rows again, 2 columns. So here you can see the number of columns in AB is equal to the number of rows in C. So they are multiplicable. So now multiply AB with C. Do this yourself. Tell me, what do you get? Well, when we multiply C with AB, we get minus 9, 68, minus 36, minus 16. So, we are done with the LHS part. Now, what do we need to do? We need to find out the RHS part and see whether we get both sides equal or not. So, what we will do here first, we will find out the bracket part, that is BC, and then multiply A with it. So, find out BC first. We have written matrix B and then matrix C. Again, you can see that the number of columns is equal to the number of rows. That is, the number of columns of B is equal to the number of rows of C. So, they are multiplicable. So, multiply this and tell me, what do you get as BC? Again, you know how to multiply two matrices. First row of the first matrix with first column of the second matrix. Then first row of the first matrix with second column of the second matrix. Again, second row of the first matrix with first column of the second matrix, and then second row of the first matrix with second column of the second matrix. Do that on your own. See, what do we get? We get BC as 18, 8, minus 9 and 20. Well, if you want, you can look at the solution also. Now, what do we need to do? We have found out BC. We need to multiply the matrix A with BC now. Well, look at the order correctly. You have to place the matrix A first and then place the matrix BC. Unlike this, where we had placed AB first and then we had placed C. So remember, this placing should be as like same as mentioned in the question. So put matrix A first and then put matrix BC. Well, you can see now that both have the same order. This has the same number of columns as this has the rows. So this is multiplicable. So now find out A into BC, that is matrix A into matrix BC. Find out the answer. See, this is a solution of A into BC. So you get minus 9, 68, minus 36, minus 16. Well, is this not familiar? Look, AB, that is matrix AB into matrix C, and matrix A into matrix BC gives you the same answer. Minus 9, minus 9, 68, 68, minus 36, minus 36, minus 16, minus 16. So you can say that AB into C is equal to A into BC. That goes also for multiplication of matrices. So multiplication of matrices is not commutative, but it is associative. This property states that multiplication of matrices is associative. Well, there is one more property that can hold. A into B plus C. Well, let's put normal numbers in C. If I say A into B plus C is AB plus AC. Well, normally whenever we do sums, we can use this. Let us verify. Say 2 into 5 plus 3. Fine. So normally what you should get, 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 into 2, 16. But if I try this method, 2 into 5 plus 2 into 3. What do you get? 5 into 2, 10 plus 2 into 3, 6. You get 16. So this is actually same. Well, does this also work with matrices? Can you tell me whether this works with matrices or not? You have to check whether these matrices A, B and C, they can be multiplied. How? By putting the order like M by N into N by P should give you M by P. The number of columns of one matrix should be equal to the number of rows of the other matrix that needs to be multiplied. So you need to first see whether whatever matrices you are using to check this property, they are confirmable for addition and multiplication both. Now, we have taken again three matrices. We can see that all these three matrices, they are confirmable for addition. Why? Because all of them have the same order. If any matrix has the same order as the other, they can be added. Also, you can see that the number of rows and the number of columns of all these matrices are same. So, all these matrices are confirmable for multiplication also. So, now when we are confirmed with this, then only we will move to checking of these, this property, whether this is distributive or not. Well, this property states that any three matrices are distributive. But now we have not come to that conclusion. First, we will see. So, let's do with LHS first. So, you can see we need to find out matrix A multiplied with the matrix of B plus C. So you can see B plus C is in the brackets first. So let us find matrix B plus matrix C. You can see that addition is very easy. Both are of the same order. Add it up and tell me what do you get as B plus C. So B plus C we get minus 1, 8, 11 and 1. So this is easy. We found out B plus C. Now we have to multiply matrix A to this resultant matrix, that is B plus C. So we have written B plus C matrix for you here and we need to multiply matrix A with this. Find it out yourself. Tell me what you get as the answer. Well, we get 32, 11, 2, minus 16. If you want, you can look at the solution also. You very well know how to multiply two matrices. Now we are done with the LHS part. What do we need to do? We need to find out the RHS part and see whether they are equal or not. So first we will find out A, B. So we have written A and B, matrix A and B for you. Find out the answer and tell me, what do you get? See, AB, we get 17, 7, minus 4 and minus 8. You can look at the solution. Now we have finished with AB. We will find out AC now. We have written A and C for you. Find out AC. AC, we get 15, 4, 6 and minus 8. Now what we need to do? We have found out AB, we have found out AC. We need to add these two matrices. So AB is this. We have to add AB with AC. This is very easy. You have to just add up two matrices. Do it. See, what do you get? 32, 11, 2, minus 16. Well, is this matrix familiar to you? Look at this. When we solved LHS, we got the same matrix. And when we are solving RHS, we got the same matrix. So A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC, as we got the same matrix, 32, 11, 2, minus 16. So this states that multiplication of matrices is not commutative, but it is associative as well as distributive.